Senator Ardman.
Hello, everyone. Do I look like my picture? That's what some people say. Boy, you look just like your picture. When I first saw that picture, I said, what is my mother doing running for the United States Senate? I look just like her, and I would have voted for her. I would vote for her now. Thank you for having me today. I'm here hoping to earn your support, and more importantly, your trust for the United States Senate race. We have a United States Senator that I don't have to tell you is a failure. He's got exactly two constituents, and none of them is you or me. His constituents, President Obama and his BFF, Harry Reid, right? He's got a 100% voting record in Washington, D.C., 100% voting for them and against Minnesota. So we all know it's time to remove Al Franken from office, and it's time for Minnesota citizens to step up and do our job. Because I have to ask, who's been doing the hiring around here anyway? How did we get a comedian for the U.S. Senate? It's time for us to step up as conservatives here in the state of Minnesota and insist on constitutional order again in Washington. It is time for our U.S. Senate to stand up to all those illegal executive orders coming out of Obama's administration, right? It's time for us to stand up and oppose the spying on our cell phones and on our internet activities, right? Isn't it time for our U.S. Senator to stand up for our constitutional rights? Admit that it was our U.S. Senator Al Franken who offered up the 60th and deciding vote for Obamacare. We have to admit that. But I'm excited to say when I'm elected to the United States Senate, Minnesota will lead the effort to repeal Obamacare and never replace it with another federal program. And we're going to attack that national debt. We begin by eliminating the annual budget gap. Every year, Congress spends almost $1 trillion more than they have coming in. We can balance that deficit just like we balanced the $5 billion deficit here in the state of Minnesota back in 2011 without raising $1 in taxes. It can be done if we elect a conservative, a fiscal conservative, to our U.S. Senate seat in Washington, D.C. And so now it's time for Minnesota conservatives to step up and lead the nation. There are folks that will step in and help us win this race. They'll help us if we pick a candidate that the nation can believe and trust. We'll stand up with courage and say no to President Obama. We'll say no to more spending, no to more government intrusion. We need a U.S. Senator with the courage of her convictions. And thank you. I know we can win because we have the best message. We have the message that we can share across the state of Minnesota. The message is this: keep your cell phone, change your senator. Keep more of your hard-earned income, change your senator. That's right. Keep your doctor, change your senator. We have the message this year. Minnesotans are ready to remove Al Franken. But I have a very important message for all of you engaged in this endorsing process. We can't afford to give Al Franken a 3-month head start. We absolutely have to endorse our very best candidate on May 30th and put her to work. I don't have to tell you that we live in the greatest nation in the world. And we are great not because our government is great, but because the people in our nation make our nation great. It's our faith. It is our commitment. It is our dedication. We can take nothing for granted because this may be the most urgent race in the nation. If we can win this race, we can take back the majority in the United States Senate and we can put a stop to the Obama-Reid liberal agenda for our nation. And more importantly, if we take back the United States Senate, we can set the stage for electing a conservative president in 2016. And we will have a nation and a government again that we can be proud of.